Hey guys, it's Miss Clark. We're going to be working on chapters 9 and 10 of Sideways Stories from Wayside School, which is pages 41 through 49. You're currently watching this on Tuesday, May 26th, 2020. So let's get started. All right, so chapter 9 is called Mauricia, and it should be on this page. And we're going to read the questions first. It says, what does Mauricia bring to school each day? And then, what does Mrs. Jules bring for Mauricia? And then number 3, why does Mauricia end up liking everyone but Kathy? Okay, so a little bit of drama in there. All right, so be thinking about these questions as we read. All right, here we go. So chapter 9, Mauricia. Mauricia liked ice cream. She was sweet and pretty and could beat up any boy in Mrs. Jules' class. Everybody liked Mauricia, except Kathy. But then she didn't like anybody. Mauricia only liked ice cream. Every day, Mauricia brought an ice cream cone to school and kept it in her desk until lunchtime. At first, she brought chocolate ice cream every day, but she soon tired of chocolate ice cream. So she started bringing vanilla. But she got tired of vanilla, too. Then she got tired of strawberry, fudge ripple, butter pecan, pistachio, and burgundy cherry, in that order. And then a terrible thing happened. Mauricia got tired of ice cream. By that time, her desk was a mess. Sticky, and everything in it was sticky. Everybody liked Mauricia, but Mauricia didn't like anything. Mrs. Jules hated to see Mauricia unhappy. I don't understand it, Mrs. Jules, cried Mauricia. There just aren't any good flavors anymore. So Mrs. Jules worked all night. The next day, she brought in a new flavor of ice cream for Mauricia. It was Mauricia-flavored ice cream. Everybody will like it, thought Mrs. Jules, because everybody likes Mauricia. Here you are, Mauricia, said Miss Jules. Mauricia-flavored ice cream. Everybody gathered around as Mauricia tasted it. They hoped she'd like it. Mauricia took a lick. Well, said Mrs. Jules. Mauricia took another lick. Well, asked the class. This ice cream has no taste, said Mauricia. It doesn't taste bad, but it doesn't taste good. It doesn't taste like anything at all. Mrs. Jules was heartbroken. Here, let me taste it, said Todd. He tasted it. You're crazy, Mauricia, he said. This is the best tasting ice cream I've ever eaten. Try some, Dee Dee. Mmm, it's delicious, said Dee Dee. So sweet and creamy. She passed it around the room. Oh, it is so good, said Leslie. I think it tastes terrible, said Kathy. I don't understand it, said Mauricia. I don't taste a thing. Mrs. Jules slapped herself in the face. Oh, I've made a big mistake, Mauricia. Of course you can't taste anything. It's Mauricia-flavored ice cream. It's the same taste you always taste when you're not tasting anything at all. So the next day, Mrs. Jules brought in Joe-flavored ice cream. Mauricia liked it. So did everybody else. Joe thought it had no taste. Everybody liked Mauricia. Mauricia only liked Joe. The following day, Mrs. Jules brought in Ron-flavored ice cream. Ron thought it had no taste, but everyone else loved it. Everybody liked Mauricia. Mauricia only liked Joe and Ron. By the end of the month, Mrs. Jules had brought in 27 new flavors of ice cream, one for each member of the class. Everybody liked Mauricia, and Mauricia liked everybody. They all tasted so good, all except Kathy, that is. Kathy-flavored ice cream tasted a little bit like old bologna. Everyone still agreed that Mauricia-flavored ice cream was the best, except Mauricia. She liked Todd ice cream the best. Mm-hmm. This turned out to be a problem. Every once in a while, Mauricia would try to take a bite out of Todd's arm in order to get that very special flavor. And that's the end of that chapter. And I'll read the questions again. It says, what does Mauricia bring to school each day? Number 2, what does Mrs. Jules bring for Mauricia? And then number 3, why does Mauricia end up liking everyone but Kathy? So go ahead and pause the video and answer the questions. And here, so your page is going to be number... We're on chapters 9 and 10. It's going to be 5-22, even though this video is taking place 5-26. Okay, so, all right, chapter 10. Oh, and also don't forget to do the character card for Maurice as well. Chapter 10, Paul. Paul had the best seat in Mrs. Jules' class. He sat in the back of the room. By the way, I think this is my favorite chapter. It was the seat that was the farthest away from Mrs. Jules. Mrs. Jules was teaching the class about fractions. She drew a picture of a pie on the blackboard. She cut the pie into 8 pieces. She explained that each piece was 1/8 of the pie. Paul never paid attention. He didn't see the picture of the pie. He didn't see anything. Well, he did see one thing. Actually, he saw 2 things. He saw Leslie's 2 pigtails. Leslie sat in front of Paul. She had 2 long brown pigtails that reached all the way down to her waist. Paul saw those pigtails and a terrible urge came over him. He wanted to pull a pigtail. He wanted to wrap his fist around it, feel the hair between his fingers, and just yank. He thought it would also be fun to tie the pigtails together, or better yet, tie them to her chair. But most of all, he just wanted to pull one. Slowly, he reached for the one on the right. No, what am I doing? He thought. I'll only get into trouble. Paul had it made. He sat in the back of the room. He paid no attention to anyone, and nobody paid any attention to him. But if he pulled a pigtail, it would be all over. Leslie would tell on him, and he'd become the center of attention. He sighed and slowly withdrew his arm. But Paul couldn't ignore those pigtails. There they were, dangling right in front of him, just begging to be pulled. He could close his eyes, but he couldn't make the pigtails disappear. He could still smell them and hear them. He could almost taste them. Maybe just a little tug, he thought. No, none. There they hung, easily within his reach. Well, let them just hang there, thought Paul. It would be foolish to pull one, no matter how tempting they were. None of the other children in the class pulled pigtails. Why should he? Of course, none of the other children sat behind Leslie either. Excuse me. It was just a simple matter of being able to think clearly. That was all. Paul thought it over and decided not to pull one. It was as simple as that. Suddenly, his arm shot forward. He grabbed Leslie's right pigtail and yanked. Yeah! Screamed Leslie. Everybody looked at her. Paul pulled my pigtail, she said. They all looked at Paul. I couldn't help it, said Paul. You'd better learn to help it, said Miss Jules. She wrote Paul's name on the blackboard under the word discipline. Tell Leslie you're sorry. I'm sorry, Leslie, said Paul. Oomph, said Leslie. Paul felt horrible. Never again would he pull another pigtail, except there was one problem. He still wasn't satisfied. He had pulled the right one, but that wasn't enough. He wanted to pull the left one, too. It was as if he heard a little voice coming from the pigtail saying, Pull me, Paul. Pull me. I can't, Paul answered. My name's already on the blackboard under the word discipline. Big deal, said the pigtail. Pull me. No way, said Paul. Never again. Ah, come on, Paul. Just a little tug, urged the pigtail. What harm could it do? Lots of harm, said Paul. Leslie will scream, and I'll get in trouble again. Boy, that's not fair, whined the pigtail. You pulled the right one. Now it's my turn. I know, but I can't, said Paul. Sure you can, said the pigtail. Just grab me and yank. All right, so we're on this page. We just finished this one. Now we're over here on this one. No, said Paul. It's not right. Sure it is, Paul, said the pigtail. Pigtails are meant to be pulled. That's what we're here for. Tell that to Leslie, said Paul. Leslie won't mind, said the pigtail. I promise.
I bet, said Paul, just like she didn't mind the last time.
You just didn't pull hard enough, said the pigtail. Leslie likes us pulled real hard.
Really? Asked Paul.
Cross my heart, said the pigtail. The harder, the better.
Okay, said Paul. But if you're lying,
I promise, said the pigtail.
Paul grabbed the left pigtail. Felt good in his hand. He pulled as hard as he could.
Yeah!
Screamed Leslie. Mrs. Jules asked, Paul, did you pull Leslie's pigtail again?
No, said Paul. I pulled the other one.
All the children laughed.
Are you trying to be funny? Asked Mrs. Jules.
No, said Paul. I was trying to be fair. I couldn't pull one, not the other.
The children laughed again.
Pigtails are meant to be pulled,
Paul concluded. Mrs. Jules put a check next to Paul's name on the blackboard under the word discipline. But at last, Paul was satisfied. True, his name was on the blackboard with a check next to it, but that really didn't matter. All he had to do was stay out of trouble the rest of the day, and his name would be erased. It's easy to stay out of trouble when you have the best seat in the class. In fact, Paul could do this every day. He could pull Leslie's pigtail twice and then stay out of trouble the rest of the day. There was nothing Leslie could do about it. Suddenly, out of nowhere, Leslie screamed, "Eeyah!" Mrs. Jules circled Paul's name and sent him home early on the kindergarten bus. Nobody would believe that he hadn't pulled Leslie's pigtail again. All right, so that was the end of chapter 10 for Paul. Number one, what does Paul have the urge to do in class? Number two, what does the author personify in this chapter and how? And then number three, why do you think Leslie screamed a third time? Okay, so those are the three questions that you're going to be answering from the packet. Also, don't forget, you're going to also do a character card for Paul. So they have little pictures of the characters already if you need some inspiration. All right, and then our exit ticket is, how would you feel if you were Kathy or Leslie? Why? Okay, so think about your answer and we'll go over it during the Google meeting. I hope you guys have a great day and I will see you then. Bye.